keyframes suck. But keyframes in Final Cut Pro, they suck even more. They're clunky, not intuitive, and worst of all, which is really surprising coming from Apple, they're inconsistent. Here's what I mean. If you keyframe the transform parameter, the position keyframes default to smooth, while the scale keyframes default to linear. So if you're animating both, which is pretty common, you end up with this weird, janky animation. And with most keyframes, you don't even have the option to change the animation type. Apple Motion actually has great keyframe controls. So it makes no sense why Apple hasn't brought that functionality over into Final Cut. Maybe one day they will. But until then, if you're animating with keyframes, you're stuck with what Final Cut gives you. And let's be honest, it's not great. But here's the good news. You don't have to use keyframes. My buddy Brad West made an animation plugin called PROANIMATE for Final Cut Pro, and it lets you create clean, professional animations in just a few clicks. No keyframes required. And today, I'm going to show you exactly how it works. Once you've downloaded PROANIMATE, installation is super simple. Just like all my plugins, it comes with an automated installer. Just double-click the file, and that's it. No messing around with folders or file paths. The installer does everything for you. After it's installed, you'll find over 240 animation presets in Final Cut Pro, available as both title and effect presets. There's a reason for both. The animations include things like bounce in and out, continuous motion, effect animations, page turns, point rotations, and a lot more. Each preset has a custom thumbnail that shows you exactly what the animation looks like, which makes browsing super quick. Blue thumbnails are in animations, green ones are out, and purple are through or continuous animations. Using them is super simple. Let's say you want to animate a clip in. Just find the animation you like, then drag and drop it onto the timeline above your clip. Want to animate faster or slower? Just ripple trim the length of the animation preset. In the inspector, you can toggle motion blur and fine-tune the animation to make it look exactly how you want. Out animations work pretty much the same. Just grab a green out preset, place it at the end of your clip, adjust the duration, and tweak the settings in the inspector. I honestly can't even imagine trying to do this with keyframes. You can also use these presets to create custom transitions. This is where the effect version comes into play. See, the title presets are adjustment layers, so they affect everything underneath it. If you overlap two clips and apply a title preset, both clips will get animated, which isn't ideal for transitions. Instead, if you apply an effect preset to just the top clip, only that one gets animated. This gives you a smooth, clean transition between the two clips without affecting the bottom one. Now, one thing to keep in mind, effect presets can't be retimed like title presets, but there is a simple workaround. If you want to use a title preset but only affect one clip, just stack the title above your clip, adjust the timing however you like, then select both the title preset and the clip, and press Option G to turn them into a compound clip. That locks the animation to just that layer while still letting you control the timing. There's so much more you can do with these animation presets. You can combine them, stack them, customize the timing, and build some pretty slick animations without ever touching a keyframe. So go and grab PROANIMATE from Brad West Media and stop wasting your time with Final Cut Pro's built-in keyframes. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.